Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Mary. Today's topic, being second best. After these things, when the wrath of King Ahasuerus was appeased, he remembered Vashti and what she had done and what was decreed against her, and the king loved Esther above all the women, and she obtained grace and favor in his sight more than all the virgins. So he set the royal crown upon her head and made her queen instead of Vashti. Esther 2, verse 1 and 17. Nobody wants to be second best. Nobody wants to know that they were not the first choice. Who wants to feel they were given a position, not because of their confidence in you, but rather because who they wanted was not available? Everyone loves to be first. If I were to ask you right now who won the 2008 Olympics finals, you'd be quick to say Usain Bolt. But if I were to ask you who came in second, without the assistance of Google, you might have some struggles in giving me that name. Everything that is not first is often overlooked. For years, I've always had struggles because I've always felt that I was never anyone's first choice for anything. I've had many positions and assignments, but then would afterwards learn that the person who they had in mind, for whatever reason, was not able to. And so, therefore, I became the substitute. I ain't gonna lie, it was a struggle dealing with this. There are times I would not want to function in the position because I felt that I was not chosen based on my merits, but rather chosen because of convenience. At the time, I was not spiritually mature enough to deal with this. The Lord had to take me to another level in Him so that I could put down my ego and accept the fact that God is in control, and what man considers as a substitute or second best, it was not by chance or done randomly, but rather done by divine design. The book of Esther illustrates that Esther was a young girl born into captivity. She was ordinary. She was not royalty. Queen Vashti had her position, but then she got on the king's bad side and lost her throne. Esther became queen, and we will learn that Esther's position was not just an appointment for herself, but she would later become the savior of her entire nation. It is difficult to deal with the fact that you're selected by man as a substitute, but one has to always bear in mind that the steps of a righteous man are ordered by the Lord. If God has placed purpose in your life, yes, you that's listening right now, if God has placed purpose in you, you might be man's second choice, but in reality, you were God's chosen all along. Man might have done all they could to prevent you from reaching your destination, but because God ordained it, it could not be stopped. So stop seeing yourself as a substitute. Stop seeing yourself as being a backup, and understand this, that what man considers as being not good enough, not up to par, not reaching their standard, is who God is looking to bring glory to His name. Yes, to man, you're a substitute, but to God, you are His chosen. The quote of the day: to man, you are a substitute, but to God, you are His chosen. As you go today, saints, go knowing. Don't let the feeling of rejection and the fact that you're not recognized by some allow you to feel less, but see yourself through God's eyes and know that you are royalty. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.